Please, Jennifer, tell the pretty people about yourself.
What he said.
All right. That's awesome.
I like to be outside. Can we go outside now? What's that?
There's no entrance. Yeah.
That's okay.
That's true. The floor is open to any questions.
Yes.
For Ekman, BW Media Spotlight. I was wondering, sometimes female voice actresses are called to play little boys because it's tough to get a little boy who can do the lines right. How do you get into the mindset of a little boy compared to...
I think I'm actually a 12-year-old boy at heart, so it's not too hard. You know, it's you spend time around little kids, and oh, thank you, hot water, you're the king. I love hot water. You spend time around little kids, and you think like them, and you remember that their machine is small, their lungs are small, their body is small. And they're doing more things, so they sound more like this. And then the way that they're doing things is a little bit more, it's just different. And they don't always have command of all the words. Yes.
Hi, Sarah from morepower.com. Do you have any, you've served prolific, obviously, do you have a favorite role that you would love to revisit?
My next one. No. I don't. I have a few that have a very, very dear place in my heart, you know. I like doing things that are out of the box that people don't expect from me. I love doing anything motion capture. That's one of my favorite ways to work. And I like the things where I've been able to break new ground, like a shepherd, you know, break ground for people. Seeing Femme Chef on the box is one of my proudest moments, I have to say. I love crazy, crazy, crazy characters like Billy's mom and Billy and Mandy and Princess Morbox. And I love some of the new style, the new sort of wave of how they're letting us act. They're letting us just think it and have a conversation instead of putting on anything. And it's a, that's a great experience. Yes.
Joshua
Alzavalli
from WCCA TV. How's it acting for an American-made game versus like a Japanese-made game that's already been made?
Mechanically, it's very different acting for an American game that you're originating versus a Japanese that you're voicing. When you're doing an American or a North American-made game, Canadian or American, you are originating it. You know, so sometimes if the production will allow, you know, if the technical constraints will allow, you can improv, you can do some fun stuff, you can banter, you can shift stuff around a little bit, you can play. With the stuff where you're revoicing, there's an additional technical requirement. You've got to bring all the acting to it, and you have to do it to picture, so you have to match the lip flaps and the timing of the other actor. And then also shift it for North American sensibilities or Western sensibilities of acting, which is a slightly different style. Yes.
Jason Lenetsky, Cosplay NYC Magazine.
Hi.
I was wondering how you felt about seeing people walking around dressed as the characters that you've voiced.
And I love it.
Have you ever decided to cosplay yourself?
I have not. There was a cosplay initiative for Mass Effect at PAX East, but I was in Australia. I couldn't make it. I love it. I love seeing people, you know, express themselves. And my friends Holly and Jessica and Chloe are on... Heroes of Cosplay, and that's an incredible, it's a great show because the craftsmanship and the work and the just what goes into it is impressive. People are amazing.
I had a question.
Yes.
What would you say are some of your most personal major difficulties being a voice actress?
It's Groundhog Day every day. You start over every day. You audition every day. There's a little bit of stuff that I get because I have worked enough. You know, people just call me to work, but I still audition every single day, start over. If I were an on-camera actor who's done the body of work that I've done, it would be financially a very different picture. I would have a lot more money. But I love my career, and I love this industry. So those are sort of two things that are like, I wish that was a little different, but it's not. So I don't focus a lot on what doesn't work for me. and move to what does and go on.
Yeah. Positive thinking.
What do you think of the transitioning success from KOTOR to Dragon Age to Mass Effect?
Clarify that question for me.
Like, how do you feel like after the games become really successful and like being like key characters in all three games?
Oh, in Mass Effect, in KOTOR.
KOTOR and Dragon Age.
I'm not, I just did my first Dragon Age session last week. It's a really groundbreaking, cool character. I'm super grateful that they asked me to do it, and I'm honored. But it's awesome. It's awesome to have be able to have done the work that I've done, to have those kind of roles. And I love carrying the flag of a strong female character. Yeah, that's a blast. Because we're ready. It's past time. Hurry up. Good. All right. I've answered all the questions in the world. Yes.
Future projects.
What can I talk about? Just worked on Dragon Age. Worked on Avengers Assemble, regular show. Got The Long Dark coming up, Canadian game, which is beautiful and going to be really exciting. Mark Meer is in that as well, Elias Defexis, so David Hayter. Republique, we're doing some more Republique, which is David Hayter as well. And it's Ryan Payton, who was on the Metal Gear team for a long time. What else? There's a lot. I can't. Lectum, Battle Mage. You others. Yes.
Play a regular show.
Oh my gosh. I'm like five characters. I can't remember who they all are, but I'm in there. IMDb will tell you. In theory. They're not always correct. How would you? Yes.
Was Femme Shepherd a bit tougher than some of the other roles? Because not only do you have to play for each direction, Joseph, have each different backstory, if like depending on which how you play the game.
Yeah, it wasn't any tougher in the sessions. It was certainly larger and denser. Like all the time in games, there are many potential avenues that you can go down. So that's always a big load in terms of line count and how much there is to do. But a four-hour session is a four-hour session, and I show up, and it's just a matter of being present every single line. That's the muscle you develop. You're present at minute one, and you're present at minute, 240. And you're present the entire time, and that's really the muscle of doing games. Yeah, it was fun.
So the video game industry is notoriously difficult for women, whether you're a creator or a customer. Mm. And obviously voice acting is more diverse because you need more female voices. But I was wondering, as a female in video games, do you often face any difficulties, or have you noticed anything that's different between you and your male?
They work more. There are more roles available to men still. I put out a challenge to all writers, directors, producers, casting people at E3, I think it was last year, and I continue to issue that challenge, which is look at your scripts. If someone's not talking about their unit, why couldn't they be female? You know, vice versa. Take gender and race and everything else off your roles. Open up your brain and just mix it up, because that's the reality of the world we live in. All right. You good?
You're welcome to ask them questions too.
Oh, I'm sad. Meaning of life, how do we get outside? Yes.
Nick DeSimone from Connecticut Cruise News. Are there any roles or genres that you would like to work in?
Anything where I can ride a horse or sing. let's see. I love mocap. I love sci-fi. Love me some sci-fi. And fantasy, I love those two genres. Yeah. Oh, 5 minutes, perfect. All right, yes.
Hi, Devin Kopeck from AntiFanboy.com. Recently I read an article, Zoe Saldana stated that space is better for women in terms of roles and acting. Mm-hmm. Is that something that kind of resonates with you? Like, do you go, oh, you know what? No, I don't know if you've ever not thought about it before, but does that seem like that's correct?
I would say it is, because a lot of space stories take place in the future. And in the future, things are more equal. So I like that notion. I like that we're headed that way. That works for me. Yeah. All right. Let's see. Any other questions? Because we can all go get a coffee. Yes.
Have you ever played any of the games that you voiced?
Oh my god. I suck at playing games. I have little to no free time. It's the most I can do to keep up with Game of Thrones, Vikings, and Top Gear. You know, it's like if I can get those in, I'm happy. Maybe a little Graham Norton thrown in on top for fun. Which, if you haven't checked out Graham Norton, do it. Such a fun show. If you watch Graham Norton, yeah, he's awesome. I was forced to play one of my games once by Tom Bissell. He's a writer for The New Yorker, and he did a profile on me a couple years ago, and he made me play Mass Effect 2, and I just wanted to go back and redo it. I was like, oh no, see, if I'd known I was doing that, I would have done that differently. That's part of it. Like, I just want to keep going and redoing it. It's essential for me to have a director in the booth. Not because I don't understand what's going on. I can fairly well at this point intuit what's going on, but I will redo and redo and redo and redo it a million different ways, and we'll never get to the end of our pile. You know, it drives me mad. I like someone to say, that works. Good, moving on. Yeah.
We have time for one more question.
Okay.
So you've had such a long and prolific career. Did you have any inspiration to go into voice acting, or was it just something that you sort of fell into naturally?
You know, it's something I fell into naturally. I went to a fine arts high school in Birmingham, and I lived in Birmingham, and I could talk without an accent. And I was working at a video production house, and they asked me to go next door to Batwell Studios and record a radio spot. And I was like, this is fun. This is cool. So I made a tape and kept remaking a tape, and I worked at like a business, you know, which is kind of how you do everything if you really want to move ahead. I worked rigorously on a schedule, following up, doing my thing, you know, and built a business out of it. Yeah. Thanks, you guys.
Awesome.
Have a beautiful day.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jennifer Hale. So please, Jennifer, tell the pretty people about yourself.
What he said.
All right. That's awesome.
I like to be outside. Can we go outside now? That's okay.
That's true. The floor is open to any questions.
Yes.
Troy Ackman, BW Media Spotlight. I was wondering.
Yes.
Sarah from morepower.com. Do you have any? You've so prolific, obviously. Do you have a favorite role that you'd love to revisit?
My next one. No. I don't. I have a few that have a very, very dear place in my heart, you know. I like doing things that are out of the box that people don't expect from me. I love doing anything motion capture.
Sometimes female voice actresses are called to play little boys because it's tough to get a little boy who can do the lines right. How do you get into the mindset of a little boy compared to...
I think I'm actually a 12-year-old boy at heart, so it's not too hard. You spend time around little kids, and oh, thank you, hot water, you're the king. I love hot water. You spend time around little kids, and you think like them, and you remember that their machine is small, their lungs are small, their body is small. And they're doing more things, so they sound more like this, and then the way that they're doing things is a little bit more, it's just different. And they don't always have command of all the words. That's one of my favorite ways to work. I like the things where I've been able to break new ground, like a shepherd, you know, break ground for people. Seeing Femme Chef on the box is one of my proudest moments, I have to say. I love crazy, crazy, crazy characters like Billy's mom and Billy and Mandy and Princess Morbox. And I love some of the new style.